terms. In the previous classes, we discussed concentration terms. Okay, so now in this lecture, let us discuss another important concept, that is the law of dilution. Okay, so before going to discuss law of dilution, first, what is the dilution? Okay, so what is dilution? Addition of solvent to the solution is called as dilution. Okay, addition of solvent to the already prepared solution. Okay, let us discuss with an example. Suppose in a bowl we have some amount of sugar is present. Okay, so we have sugar is taken in a container, and this one, so this is n moles of sugar is present. Okay, so for this we are adding water. For the sugar, suppose we are adding 1 liter of water. Now what happened here? 1 liter of sugar solution is formed. So no, for the sugar, n moles of sugar, we have added 1 liter of water. Now 1 liter of sugar solution is formed. For this, now we are adding some extra amount of water, because here water is a solvent and sugar is a solute. Okay, so now here what happens, after adding extra amount of water, now this solution is diluted. Yes or no? Because we are adding a solvent, extra amount of solvent. Suppose for example here we are adding 1 liter. So now what happens, this 1 liter sugar solution becomes 2 liter of sugar solution. Yes or no? For the 1 liter sugar solution, we are adding 1 more liter of solvent. Now here, see, is we are adding sugar here? No, we are just adding solvent. Means in 1 liter of solution, we have n moles of sugar, and in the 2 liter of solution also, we have n moles of sugar. Yes or no? In 1 liter also, we have n moles of sugar, and in the 2 liter also we have n moles of sugar. Means the number of moles of sugar, that is a solute, general case. Okay, so number of moles of solute is a constant. Okay, before dilution and after dilution, same moles of solute will be present. Okay, so that is a very very important condition in the dilution process. So in the dilution, number of moles of solute remains constant. Yes or no? Here also we have n moles, here also we have n moles of solute. But concentration is changing. Yes or no? Here in 1 liter n moles is present, in here in 2 liter n moles is present. Here sweetness is different. Here we have less sweetness when compared to this case. Yes or no? Now, this first prepared solution is called as concentrated solution here. And after adding solvent, the formed solution is called as a diluted solution. Okay, first prepared, original prepared solution is concentrated solution, and after adding solvent, the formed solution is called as diluted solution. Okay, so now this we can write, number of moles of solute is equal to constant. Okay, number of moles is not changing. Yes or no? Okay, so we know this relation, already discussed in the molarity concept. Number of moles equal to molarity into volume in liter. Yes or no? Okay, now substitute here. So in dilution, M into V is equal to constant. Yes or no? Molarity into volume is constant. Molarity changes and volume changes, but molarity into volume is constant here. Now, suppose before dilution, we are assuming molarity is M1 and volume is V1. So, we can write N equal to M1 into V1. Okay, and after dilution, number of moles of solute equal to M2 into V2. Okay, but here what is happening overall in the dilution process, the number of moles of solute remains constant. So that's why we can write M1 into V1 equal to M2 into V2. Yes or no? So M into V is constant, means M1 V1 equal to M2 V2. So this is M1 V1, this is for the concentrated solution, and this is for the dilute solution, means after addition of solvent to the original solution which we are taking. Okay, clear? So this is about law of dilution. Okay, so m1v1 equal to m2v2, this is law of dilution. The only thing you should remember is that what happens, number of moles of the solute remains constant in the dilution process, and n equal to m into v, from that we are getting this relation. Okay, clear? So this one, we can explain this law of dilution with respect to normality also here. Now let us discuss the law of dilution when concentration is expressed in terms of normality. Okay, so when concentration is expressed in terms of molarity, so we have discussed that in dilution, number of moles of solute remains constant, right? Now if the concentration is expressed in normality, in the dilution, number of equivalents of solute remains constant, that is the only difference. If concentration is expressed in molarity, number of moles remains constant. And when the concentration is expressed in normality, number of equivalents, GEN of solute remains constant. Okay, so this we can write. So GEN of solute is equal to constant. So no, so that is before dilution and after dilution, number of equivalents of solute is same. Okay, so now GEN equal to, what is the relation? GEN equal to normality into volume in liter. Already we discussed this relation in the normality concept. Okay, so GN equal to N into V in liter. Now we can write, suppose before dilution GEN equal to N1 into V1. Okay, right? After dilution we can write, okay, after dilution, GEN equal to N2 into V2. Okay, so therefore, number of equivalents of solute is same before dilution and after dilution. So we can write N1 into V1 equal to N2 into V2. Okay, so this is the law of dilution when concentration is expressed in normality. Okay, so this is for the concentrated solution, means before the addition of extra solvent, and this is for the dilute solution after addition of solvent to the solution or after dilution. Okay, clear? So when concentration is expressed in molarity, number of moles of solute is constant, there we are getting m1v1 equal to m2v2. When concentration is expressed in normality, we are getting n1v1 equal to n2v2. Okay, now let us see two problems. What is the final volume of 10 ml of 10 molar HCl solution when it is diluted to 0.1 molar? Okay, so here first concentrated solution, yes or no? The original solution which is given, we are assuming that as concentrated solution, right? So here its molarity equal to M1, that is how much, 10 molar provided. And the volume is V1, how much, 10 milliliter, right? And for the dilute solution, means after dilution, this solution's concentration is changed to 0.1 molar. And we should find the final volume of the solution. Yes or no? So this is the given problem. Okay. So for the original solution, concentration and volume are provided. And for the final solution, that is for the dilute solution, concentration is provided, we have to find the final volume. Okay, so this we have to use which relation? M1V1 equal to M2V2. Sir, no, so this is the relation we have to use here. M1 is how much? 10. V1 is how much? 10. M2 is 0.1, that we can write 10 power minus 1 into V2. Okay, clear? So here, if we rearrange this, V2 equal to 10 into 10 by 10 power minus 1. See, this goes into up. Okay, so that becomes 10 power 1. So 10 into 10 into 10, that becomes 1000. Therefore, V2, that is final volume, is equal to 1000 milliliter. Okay, see here, one more thing you should be careful about, the units of volume. Okay, if in the options, in the examination, the volume is given in the liters. Okay, so here you have to take volume in the liter. Finally, here we get 1 liter. 1000 into 10 power minus 3 liter means that is 1 liter. Okay, so depending upon the units for the volume given in the problem, you have to take volume either in the milliliter or in the liters. Okay, there you should be careful. Now, let us see the problem, this one. How much water is needed to dilute 10 ml of 10 molar HCl to make it 0.1 molar solution? See, same quantities. Okay, here also HCl solution is the same initial volume and concentration. Here also same. And the only difference between the two problems, look at here. What is the final volume we should find in this question? And here, how much water is needed? Okay, with the same information, question can be asked in two ways. Very, very important. Okay, you should be very careful. So here we are finding final volume, right? But here, how much water is needed? Okay, see, up to this, for concentrated solution, M1 is how much? 10 molar. Volume is equal to 10 ml. Okay, and for the dilute solution, molarity M2 equal to 0.1 molar and V2, we don't know that, first we should find. Okay, see, up to here same procedure. Okay, here also up to here same procedure. So from M1 V1 equal to M2 V2. Okay, substitute here 10 into 10 equal to 0.1, that is 10 power minus 1 into V2. So here we are getting 1000 milliliter. Okay, up to here both the problems are same. And now, here final volume is the question, so we stopped here. But here, how much water is needed? Okay, so therefore, volume of water added equal to V2 minus V1, yes or no? For V1 amount of solution we have added some volume of water, then we are getting this final volume, okay? So to get the how much water is added, simple, subtract the initial volume from the final volume, that is final how much? 1000 milliliter. Initial is 10 milliliter, so we get 990 milliliter. Okay, so this is the way how to solve law of dilution related problems. So you should be very, very careful here. Okay, maybe what is the final volume, one type of possible question. Another type is how much solvent, here water is the solvent, so that's why how much solvent is needed to prepare this concentrated solution. Okay, so very, you should be careful here. If they ask you to find the final volume, just stop here at V2. Or if they ask you to find how much solvent is added in the dilution, just to do up to here same, and finally final volume minus initial volume. Okay, thank you.